गुड मॉर्निंग मैम. आई एम पी कविता. आई एम वर्किंग एज अ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट लेक्चरर इन मैथमेटिक्स. नाउ आई विल टीच एमएससी स्टैटिस्टिक्स पेपर दैट इज लीनियर अलजेब्रा 1 दैट इज फोर्थ यूनिट लास्ट टॉपिक. आई विल शेयर द स्क्रीन. Hello, my is it screen visible?
Share it, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Hello, my screen share out on the. Hello.
Out on, ma'am.
Ah, sorry. Where we stopped in the last class? The problem again? Hello? Please give response. Hello? In this theorem, see here. Ui value is 1 by norm avi into avi. That can be written as 1 by sigma I into avi. From this, avi value is sigma I into ui. But I value 1 less than or equal to I less than or equal to r are the. Problem is, find the singular value decomposition of the matrix A. We have to told. That is, capital matrix is 4. A help find the singular value decomposition of the matrix A. That is the problem. Consider A dash. That is, A value is 4, row wise 4, 11, 14, 8, 7, minus 2. A dash value is, we are transposing row, transpose value is, we are interchanging row as column. That is 4, 11, 14, first row as first column, second row as second column, that is 8, 7, minus 2. Now we are calculating A dash into A. After writing A dash into A, we have got 80, 140, that value. Consider, we have to calculate determinant A dash A minus lambda I. That is, which is in the form of AI, but that is not correct. Formula is det A dash A minus lambda equal to 0. Our first step is wrong. Next, det A dash A value is 80, 140, 100, 170, 140, 168, 140, 200 minus lambda is lambda value lambda. Into I value is 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. Lambda into 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 value is lambda 0 0 0 lambda 0 0 0 lambda. Its determinant value is equal to 0. This is equation. A dash A det A dash A minus lambda I equal to 0. Therefore, from this, we will get det A t minus, we are subtracting first matrix minus second matrix, we will get 80 minus lambda, 100, 40, 100, 170 minus lambda. Diagonal elements we are subtracting, remaining elements are same elements. That is 80 minus lambda, 100, 40 first row, Second row, 100, 170 minus lambda, 140. Third row, 168, 140, 200 minus lambda. From this, you know this method to calculate the characteristic equation, characteristic vector, characteristic root, that is determinant value is equal to 0. That is first value 80 minus lambda into a determinant. We are eliminating first row and first column, that is minus 170 minus lambda into 200 minus lambda, minus 140 into 140, that is 196 00, minus second term 100 into we are eliminating first row and first row and second column, then we will get getting the equation in lambdas. See this, you know very well. Then we will get the equation, which is in the form, that is minus lambda cube plus 450 lambda square minus 32400 lambda. This can be written as minus lambda, we are taking common, lambda square root minus 450. After solving this, we will get this equation, that is minus lambda cube plus 450 lambda square minus 32400 lambda, we will get, that is equal to 0. We are taking minus lambda is taking common, lambda square minus 450 lambda plus 32400, which is equal to 0. After solving this, we will get minus lambda into lambda minus 360, lambda minus 90 is equal to 0. Please check this later. Then we will get the lambda values, three values, that is lambda equal to 0 and lambda equal to 90 and lambda equal to 360. We are calculating the after calculating the above equation, we have got three roots, that is 360, three characteristic roots. Three characteristic roots are different roots, distinct roots. The characteristic roots are lambda equal to 0, one characteristic root, lambda equal to 90, and lambda equal to 360. These are the characteristic roots. Now, characteristic vector corresponding to lambda 1, we are taking. We have got three values, 0, 90, 360. Now we are taking one value, lambda 1, as 360. Therefore, further characteristic vector, we have to calculate characteristic vector. Characteristic vector key, that is equation is a dash a minus lambda 1 into I overall ga x1 is equal to 0. Corresponding to lambda 1, we are calculating characteristic vector. That is equation is a dash into a minus lambda 1 into I of x1 equal to 0. Already in the before phase, we have calculated a dash a, that is 80 minus a dash a minus lambda I, we have calculated. In that lambda, we will substitute lambda 1 value, but lambda 1 value is 360. We are substituting 80 minus lambda place, we are substituting 80 minus 360, that is lambda 1. Next 140, same 100, 170 minus lambda, we are substituting lambda place, we are substituting lambda 1. Lambda 1 value is 360, 140 as it is. Next 40, 140, 200 minus 200 minus 360. We are substituting the value of, in place of lambda, we are substituting the value of lambda 1, that is 360. Then we have got equation, capital X is x1, x2, x3. Capital X1 value, that is characteristic vector corresponding to lambda 1 value. X1 value is x1, x2, x3. The right side is 0, that is 0, 0, 0. After calculating this, 80 minus 360, that is minus 280. Next remaining element same. Like second row 100, second element minus 190, 140, remaining element same. Next 40, 140, 200 minus 360, that is minus 160 into x3, next vector, that is the next matrix x1, x2, x3, that is equal to O. After calculating this, we will get three equations. That is, first matrix in first row minus 280, 100, 40 into second matrix x1, x2, x3 column wise. We are multiplying these two. That is, we will get minus 280 x1 plus 100 x2 plus 40 x3. That is equal to right side value equal to 0. You have to write equal to 0. That is equation 1. Similarly, second row column 100 x1 plus minus 190 x2 plus 140 x3. That is also equal to 0. You have to write that is equation 2. Next, 40 x1 plus 140 x2 minus 160 x3 is equal to 0. That is equation 3. We are solving 1 and 3. We are making as x1 coefficient same. Equation 1 low minus 280 x1. X1 coefficient is minus 280. Equation 3, x1 coefficient is 40. Now we are multiplying equation 1 into 7. Equation 3 into 7. For equation 1 as it is, that is minus 280 x1 plus 100 x2 plus 40 x3 as it is. Now we are multiplying equation 3 by 7. 7 into 40 into 280 x1. No? Next to 7 into 14, that is 980 x2 minus remaining terms same. Which is minus 280 x1 plus 280 x1 ante 0. Next remaining terms rastunamo, we are adding, and then from this we will get one x2 value is x2 equal to x3 value, that is equal to, we are taking 1, say. We are assuming x2 value is equal to 1, then x3 is also equal to 1. Similarly, equation in substituting equation 3, we will get x1. We are solving 1 and 3, we have got x2 equal to x3, same. Let us take x3 equal to 1, then x2 is also equal to 1. In substituting equation 3, we have got x1 equal to 1 by 2. Please take it. X1 is 1 by 2. Now we are writing the characteristic vector capital X1 is column wise x1, x2, x3. But x1 value is 1 by 2, x2 value is 1, x3 value is 1. That is the characteristic vector capital X1 value. We have got column wise 1 by 2, 1, 1. This is the characteristic vector corresponding to characteristic root lambda 1 equal to 360. Similarly, characteristic vector corresponding to lambda equal to 90 mod. Lambda equal to 90. It is seeing like 10, but it is not 10. Its value is 90. Now lambda 2 value is 90. That is a dash a minus lambda 2. You have to write lambda 2 I of x2 is equal to 0. Lambda 2 ki corresponding one characteristic vector we are calculating. That is a dash a minus lambda 2 into I of x2 is equal to 0. A dash a is 80 minus lambda value is 90. 80 minus 90, 140 first row. Second row 100, 170 minus lambda value is 90, 140. Third row is 40, 140, 200 minus 90, x1, x2, x3, which is equal to 0, 0, 0. Now we are calculating this. After calculating this, minus 10, 140, 180, 140, next 40, 140, 110 into x1, x2, x3 equal to 0, 0, 0. Now, in the left-hand side, we are taking multiplication. We are taking the product, that is first row column, minus 10x1 plus 100x2 plus 40x3 equal to, right side equal to 0, you have to write. Similarly, 100x1 plus 80x2 plus 140x3 is equal to 0, you have to write, that is equation 2. Similarly, 40x1 plus 140x2 plus 110x3 is equal to 0, that is equation 3. You have to find x1, x2, x3. Solving 1 and 2, in the equation 1, x1 coefficient is minus 10 only. In equation 2, x1 coefficient 100. Then, now we are multiplying equation 1 with 10. Therefore, solving equation 1 into 10 plus adding 2. That is equation 1 into 10 means 10 into minus 10 is minus 100x1 plus 100x2 into 10 and 1000x2 plus 40 into 10 and 400x3. Which is equal to 0, that is equation 1. This we got by multiplying 10 2 equation 1. Take second equation as it is. After adding these two equations, we have got after adding these two equations, we have got 2x2 plus x3 equal to 0. Then 2x2 equal to minus x3. This can be written as x2 by x3 is equal to minus 1 by 2. Otherwise, x2 by minus 1 is equal to x3 by 2 can also be written. Therefore, its value, x2 value is minus 1 and x3 value is 2. We have got x2 value minus 1, x3 value 2. Now, these two values, substituting in any equation, we will get x1. Now, we are substituting this in equation 3. Then, we have got x1 value is minus 2. Please check it. X1 is minus 2 and x2 is minus 1, x3 is 2. Therefore, capital X is equal to capital X or capital X2. Let us take capital X2. That is a characteristic vector corresponding to the characteristic second characteristic vector lambda 2 equal to 90. Therefore, capital X2 equal to x1 minus 2, x2 value minus 1, x3 value 2. Column wise vector, capital X2 is this value. Now, we are calculating characteristic vector corresponding to lambda equal to 0. Okay, lambda equal to 0 corresponding on a characteristic vector we are calculating. That is 80 minus lambda and lambda value 0 out actual matrix. So, 80, 100, 40, 100, 170 minus lambda also 170 minus 0. That is 170, 140. Next remaining terms as it is, that is x1, x2, x3, which is equal to 0, 0, 0. These are the questions in unit 2, 4 important questions. Gram scheme editor, next definition, QF, quadratic form. These are the important questions. Next, I will tell. Our problem is continuation, that is 80 x1 plus 100 x2 plus 40 x3 equal to 0, that is equation 1. Next, similarly 100 x1 plus 170 x2 plus 140 x3 equal to 0, that is equation 2. Similarly, third row multiplication matrix x1, x2, x3, that is 40 x1 plus 170 x2 plus 200 x3 equal to 0, that is equation 3. In equation 1, x1 coefficient 80, in equation 3 x1 coefficient 40. Now we are multiplying equation 3 with 2 and subtracting equation 1. Then we got equation 1 is 80 x1 plus 100 x2 plus 40 x3 equal to 0. And equation 3 we are multiplying 2, that is 2 into 40 80x1, 2 into 170 280x2 plus 2 into 200 400 x3 equal to 0. We are subtracting these two equations. X1 term remains, X1 term becomes 0. X2 terms we got minus 180 X2 minus 360 X3 equal to 0. Dividing with 180, we get minus X2 minus 2X3 equal to 0. Then minus X2 equal to plus 2X3.
Ma'am, one small doubt, ma'am. Equation 3 low 170 raagudu, ma'am.
Question,
ma'am. దాంట్లో మ్యామ్ ఈక్వేషన్ ఇప్పుడు చెప్పే దాంట్లో ఈక్వేషన్ 3 వచ్చి 170 రాకూడదు మ్యామ్
15 ఓకే అక్కడ 140 ఉందా
అవును మ్యామ్
సరే యు హావ్ టు చెక్ ద సరే వాల్యూ మనకి x2 ఇస్ ప్లీజ్ వెరిఫై అండ్ రైట్ కరెక్ట్లీ Sir, after solving these equations, x2 minus x2 by x3, that is x2 value is minus 2, x3 value is 1. Now, in substituting equation 3, we get x1 is 2. Therefore, capital x3 value is, you have to write capital x3, that is x3 is 2 minus 2, 1. Now, for three characteristic vectors, for three characteristic values, lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3, we have got three characteristic vectors, that is capital X1, capital X2, capital X3. Lambda 1 equal to 360, we have got capital X1. lambda 1, lambda 2 equal to 90, we have got capital X2. Lambda equal to 0, we have got capital X3. Therefore, we are writing these three values. Now we are calculating capital V1. V1 matrix calculate chestunamo. V1 value is cap formula is capital X1 by norm X1. For this calculation, I will send one document after this class. Just to listen. V1 value is equal to capital X1 by norm X1. X1 that is first characteristic vector. For the lambda equal to 360 characteristic vector is X1 is 1 by 2, 1, 1. Like lambda equal to 90 for that vector characteristic vector is for that value characteristic vector is lambda equal to 90 x2 equal to minus 2 minus 1 2 lambda equal to 0 corresponding characteristic vector is now we have got last value x value that is 2 minus 2 1 therefore now we are calculating v1 is x1 value but x1 value by norm x1 where x1 value is right side 2 by 3 k right side multiplication that is x1 x1 value 1 by 2 1 1 this is the characteristic vector for lambda 1 equal to 360 value e 1 by e vector x1 vector 1 by 2 1 1 undi by norm of x1 can be written as you have to write this formula in some paper norm x1 is square root of x1 comma x1 x1 is 1 by 2 1 1 and 1 by 2 1 x1 is 1 by 2 1 1 that is 1 by 2 whole square root plus 1 square root plus 1 square 1 by 2 whole square means 1 by 4 plus 1 square into 1 plus 1 square into 1 1 by 4 plus 1 plus 1 and my norm x1 formula is square root of x1 comma x1 లేదు ఇగ్నో స్క్వేర్ రూట్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్స్ వన్ స్క్వేర్ పెట్టచ్చు ఎక్స్ వన్ స్క్వేర్ వాల్యూ ఈస్ వన్ బై టూ హోల్ స్క్వేర్ ప్లస్ వన్ స్క్వేర్ ప్లస్ వన్ స్క్వేర్ వన్ బై టూ హోల్ స్క్వేర్ అంటే వన్ బై ఫోర్ ప్లస్ వన్ ప్లస్ వన్ ఆఫ్టర్ టేకింగ్ ఎల్సిఎం వీ విల్ గెట్ ఫోర్ డినామినేటర్ ఫోర్ దట్ ఈస్ వన్ బై ఫోర్ ప్లస్ వన్ అంటే దట్ ఈస్ వన్ ప్లస్ ఫోర్ ఇంటూ వన్ ఈస్ వన్ ప్లస్ ఫోర్ ప్లస్ ఫోర్ దట్ ఈస్ నైన్ బై ఫోర్ వీ విల్ గెట్ రూట్ ఆఫ్ నైన్ బై ఫోర్ ఈస్ త్రీ బై టూ our v1 formula is x1 by norm x1 undi x1 ante 1 by 2 1 1 anedi as it is 1 by norm x1 can be written as 1 by 3 by 2 value that is 1 by 3 by 2 value is it comes to the numerator that is 2 by 3 2 by 3 into x1 value is 1 by 2 1 1 is it understood ma 2 by 3 into 1 by 2 means we will get 1 by 3 2 2 gets cancelled second term 2 by 3 into 1 into 2 by 3 third term 2 by 3 into 1 and 2 by 3 Emma is it understood v1 value anyone respond
yes ma'am
similarly v2 we are calculating v2 is x2 by norm x2 v2 norm x2 value x2 value is second matrix that is minus 2 1 minus 1 2 norm x2 is square root of minus 2 square root square root of minus 2 square root plus minus 1 square root plus 2 square root. That is 2 square 4 root, 1 square into 1 plus 2 square into 4. 4 plus 1 plus 4 into 8, 9 root. That is root 9 value is 3. 1 by norm x2 value is 1 by 3. 1 by 3 into x2 value into minus 2 minus 1 2. Both the we are multiply after multiplying this we will get minus 2 by 3 minus 1 by 3 2 by 3. Next, V3 value. With in the similar manner, you have to calculate X3. X3 by norm X3. This is also 1 by 3, 2 minus 2, 1. Similarly, its value is also 2 by 3, minus 2 by 3, 1 by 3. Now, we are writing V matrix. V matrix is V1, V2, V3. Column wise, you have to write. V1 value column wise 1 by 3, 2 by 3, 2 by 3. Therefore, we are writing as first column. V matrix is row wise 1 by v1 v2 v3 you have to write but v1 is column wise 1 by 3 2 by 3 2 by 3 అనేది ఫస్ట్ మ్యాట్రిక్స్ ద that is v equal to first column 1 by 3 2 by 3 to 2 by 3. Next second column minus 2 by 3 minus 1 by 3 2 by 3. Next third column v3 value, that is 2 by 3 minus 2 by 3 1 by 3. In this way you have to write v. Next consider u1 formula. U1 formula is 1 by sigma 1 into av1. You have to calculate av1. V1 value already we know that. A into V1 we have to calculate. Emma? This next document lo pettana. Next document lo le. Already we have calculated. 1 minute. Sir, I will send the photo next after the class. Its value is. Ikkada un value is 1 by sigma 1 into av1. Please listen, sigma 1 formula is sigma I into root of lambda I, that is sigma i value is root of lambda I. Manaki sigma 1 value is root of lambda 1. Root of lambda 1 value, lambda 1 value 360, that is root lambda, root of 360 value is 6 root 10. After the class, I will send the another document for this explanation. Emma, u1 equal to 1 by sigma 1 into av1 undi. Sigma 1 value is root lambda I. Sigma I formula is root of lambda I. But root of 360 means that can be written as 6 root 10. Root of 360 value is 6 root 10. That is sigma 1. Sigma 1 value is root 6 root 10, then AV1 value we will calculate. AV1 value, A and A matrix, so that is 4, 11, 14, 8, 7, -2. V1 value we will calculate more. V1 value already we have written 1 by 3 a value undi. AV1 and A into V1, after calculating U1 value is 1 by sigma 1 into AV1. AV1 value, the total value we will get 3 by root 10, 1 by root 10. 1 by sigma value is 6 by root 10, you will get. AV1 value is 18, 6 you will get. After calculating, after cancelling 6, you will get 3 by root 10, 1 by root 10. I will post this explanation later. U1 value, consider un value is equal to 1 by sigma 1, av1 value is 3 by root 10 similarly. In the same way, you have to calculate u2. U2 is 1 by sigma 2, av2. Sigma value is, sigma I value is root of lambda I, we know that. The lambda 2 value 90, that is sigma 2 value is root of 90. Root of 90 can be written as, 9 can be written as 3 square into 10, that is 3 root 10 you will get. Sigma 2 value 3 root 10 you will get. 1 by sigma 2 ante 1 by 3 root 10 you will get. And A into V2 you have to multiply its value. And after simplifying 1 by sigma 2 into AV2, you will get 1 by root 10 minus 3 by root 10. Next, then U can be written as U equal to U1 U2. But U1 value is 3 by root 10, 1 by root 10 first column. U2 value is 1 by root 10 minus 3 by root 10. Then U equal to U1, U2 and V equal to V1, V2, V3. We will write. Next, D value is sigma 1, 0, 0, sigma 2. We have to write. But sigma 1 value already we have calculated 6. Sigma 1 value 6 root 10 amadi. 6 root 10 ena. 6 root 10 undi. Sigma 1 value 6 by rasunnaru. Sir, I will calculate and later I will send. D value is sigma 1 0 0 sigma 2 alal. Sigma 1 sigma 2 value substitute chestam. And E value, E matrix. మనకి డయాగనల్ మ్యాట్రిక్స్ 0-0 ఫామ్ చెప్పున్నాము. డయాగనల్ అక్కడ 6 వాల్యూ అది ఉంది 0-0. నెక్స్ట్ సెకండ్ రో 0, ఆ డయాగనల్ వాల్యూ 0. Now we will calculate A equal to U into sigma into V dash. This you will check. Multiply U, sigma and V dash. V dash is the transpose of V. Then we will get A. This is for assignment to give. This is for assignment you have to write. Therefore, unit 4 is over. I will share the next screen. Next to unit 2, this is the last topic, last unit we have to cover. Unit 1, 3 and 4 is over. Remaining is unit 2 only. Unit 2 topic, that is heading is finite dimensional vector space and subspace, linear dependence and linear independence, basis and dimensions of vector space, completion theorem, inner product space, orthonormal basis, Gram's commutative orthogonalization process, orthogonal projection of a vector. These are the topics in unit 2. Unit 2 also you have studied in degree also, that is a degree final year linear algebra paper in mathematics. Similarly, introduction. Classical algebra deals with various systems of members in relation to the two direct compositions of addition and multiplication and the two corresponding inverse compositions, subtraction and division. Classical algebra deals with various systems of members in relation to the direct compositions or addition and multiplication and two corresponding inverse compositions are subtraction and division. Next, the system of rational numbers, real numbers and complex numbers play a very important role. While these three real numbers, rational numbers and complex numbers. What are the real numbers? First, what is the natural numbers? Anyone respond? Natural numbers starting from already told, I have told already last classes, n is
1 to infinity.
Ma respond avandi, what is
1 n to ma? Infinity madam.
N is natural numbers 1 2 3 and so on. Next, integers. My integers
negative natural numbers plus positive natural numbers.
Not audible ma.
Negative natural numbers, yep. 0 plus positive natural numbers.
Natural numbers 1, 2, 3 and so on. No? Integers 0 plus or minus 1 plus or minus 2 and so on. Next, positive integers are plus 1, plus 2, plus 3 and so on. Negative integers are minus 1, minus 2 and so on, minus 3. Now real numbers. Real number, n is subset of z, z is subset of z is subset of Q, Q is subset of R. Rational numbers, which are rational numbers, which are in the form P by Q, where Q not equal to 0, which is in the form of P by Q, then rational numbers. Now, we know that N is subset of Z, Z is subset of Q, Q is subset of R, but R is subset of C. That is, N means natural numbers, Z means integers, Q means rational numbers, which is in the form of P by Q, and R means real numbers, R denotes, and C means complex numbers. Complex numbers is which is in the form A plus IB or X plus IY. Then X is the real part of complex number and Y is the imaginary part of complex number, and I square value is equal to minus 1. We know that. Therefore, the system of rational numbers, real numbers, and complex numbers play a very important role, while these three systems have different properties. These three systems have different properties. However, there exists a set of properties shared by each systems of them. These three systems have different properties. However, there exists a set of properties shared by each systems of the three and more. And three sets of numbers, different type of properties exist. That means, next, the system of rational, real, and complex numbers shall be denoted by Q, R, and C respectively. That is, the system of rational numbers is denoting by capital Q. And system of real numbers we are denoting by capital R. And the system of complex numbers we are denoting capital C respectively. We shall use the symbol capital F to denote without discrimination each of these three systems while discussing the common properties of Q, R, and C. We are using common symbol capital F. We know that capital F in degree you have studied. In degree, capital F means F is the field end. Already you have studied, ma? But do you know that capital F is a field?
Yes, ma'am.
But now we are defining definition of a field. Definition of a field. This one is also already we have studied in degree level. A field is a set or system together with some properties on the objects in that set, which behave like ordinary addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division of numbers, in the sense that they obey the following 11 rules of algebra. It is denoted by Fm. F is a field that is a set together with some operations on the objects in the set which behave like ordinary addition operations, ordinary addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division of numbers, in the sense that they obey the following 11 rules. 11 rules is satisfying, some set is satisfying the following 11 rules, then we say that F is a field end. Anyone can say the definition of what are the 11 properties of a field? Already you have studied. Can anyone say? Sir, first group conditions. Please tell me the conditions of group. Hello? My group conditions, A condition satisfy the group vastundi.
I'm closer property, identity property, inverse property.
Closure, associativity, identity, inverse condition satisfy chesthi. Any set is satisfying the four conditions, then we say that G is a group antam. In addition to that, it is also satisfying the commutative property, then we say that commutative group one. The total five conditions. Commutative group means total five conditions, that is binary operation or closure, associative property, identity property, inverse, commutative, up to five conditions. Any set is satisfying these five conditions, then we say that abelian group. There plus is a binary operation, then we say that G is an abelian group with respect to the operation plus one. Or G comma dot is a binary operation, then also we say that the five conditions is satisfying the set G, then we say that G is a commutative, G comma dot is a commutative group with respect to dot any. We know that. Now here F is said to be field antonamo. It is satisfying the 11 rules of algebra. It is denoted by capital F. We are denoting field as capital F. Properties of capital F. Properties of capital F. first f comma plus is abelian and we have abelian condition is f comma plus is abelian condition and f is a abelian group avutondi with respect to plus n plus ante binary operation plus n that property is we are denoting as a1 you have to remember these conditions of definition of a field if definition of field is satisfying 11 conditions first one is with respect properties of addition no? With respect to addition we are defining the five conditions a1 is addition first condition and closure is set we are taking as a field my f1 we are taking set as f in the in groups we are taking set g aithe group ikkada field aithe f1 define chestunnam if a belongs to f anedi field ani cheptunnam f anedi field andulo two elements a comma b we are taking any two elements a comma b belongs to f then a plus b also belongs to f a is one element and b is one element a plus b also belongs to f then this is plus c is satisfying the closure condition or binary operation can also be say that second a2 associative condition if a comma b comma c belongs to f then a plus b plus c is equal to a plus b plus c addition with respect to addition ante binary operation plus ade with respect to dot aithe sare circle aithe a circle b circle c equal to a circle b circle c a circle b circle c equal to a circle b circle c instead of circle we are having plus that is a plus b plus c equal to a plus b plus c next a3 neutral element antunnamo neutral element is nothing but identity property with respect to addition maniki we are in groups the identity property with respect to addition is a plus e equal to a where e is the identity element with respect to addition is a e is 0 that is a plus 0 equal to 0 plus a equal to e ikkada 0 is the additive identity element antamo or identity element with respect to addition antam in groups similar way A3 is neutral element and neutral element or identity same property there exists a number a comma number 0 belongs to f such that ikkada oka number 0 belongs to f such that a plus 0 equal to 0 plus a equal to a for all a belongs to f a anedi one element in belongs to f then corresponding any number 0 belongs to f such that a plus 0 equal to a or 0 plus a equal to 0 this is the identity condition with respect to addition with respect to addition identity element is 0 next inverse condition a4 is inverse condition in inverse condition inverse law is a circle a inverse equal to a inverse circle a equal to e instead of circle binary operation ikkada manaki plus therefore to each a belongs to f there corresponds b equal to minus c such that a plus b equal to 0 manaki a plus of minus c equal to 0 aithe a plus a ki inverse minus c antam avuna similarly general definition is to each a belongs to f there corresponds b equal to minus c such that a plus b equal to 0 this can also be written as a plus minus a equal to minus a plus e plus a equal to 0 that is 0 is identity n this is the inverse condition similarly commutative condition for all a comma b belongs to f then a plus b equal to b plus c same circle is a circle b equal to b circle a same these are the conditions of abelian group అక్కడ ఎఫ్ కమా ప్లస్ అనేది మనం డిఫైన్ చేసిన ఫస్ట్ ఫైవ్ కండిషన్స్ ఏమంటే ఎఫ్ కమా ప్లస్ ఈజ్ అన్ అబిలియన్ గ్రూప్ అని అబిలియన్ గ్రూప్ అంటే దట్ ఈస్ సాటిస్ఫైయింగ్ ది ఫైవ్ కండిషన్స్ వన్ ఈజ్ క్లోజర్ సెకండ్ వన్ ఈజ్ అసోసియేటివ్ థర్డ్ వన్ ఈజ్ న్యూట్రల్ ఎలిమెంట్ ఆర్ ఐడెంటిటీ ప్రాపర్టీ ఫోర్త్ వన్ ఇన్వర్స్ ఫిఫ్త్ వన్ కామ్యుటేటివిటీ నెక్స్ట్ ప్రాపర్టీస్ ఆఫ్ మల్టిప్లికేషన్ ప్రాపర్టీస్ ఆఫ్ మల్టిప్లికేషన్ these are the f comma dot is an abelian these are the five conditions with respect to multiplication dot and the binary operation. That is f comma dot is binary operation. First condition m1. M1 and with respect to multiplication, we are m1, and we are denoting m1. M1 is closure. That is, if A belongs to F, comma B belongs to F, then A, comma B belongs to F. Next, M2 is associative. Associative condition A into B into C equal to AB into C for all ABC belongs to F. Next, M3 is neutral element. Neutral element are, that is nothing but a identity condition. There exists a number. Identity with respect to multiplication is 1. Therefore, there exists a number 1 belongs to F such that A into 1 equal to 1 into A equal to A for all A belongs to F. Next, M4, inverse condition. Inverse condition is to each A not equal to 0, there exists B belongs to F such that AB equal to 1 equal to BA. That is, A into A inverse equal to E, or E, A inverse into A equal to E. Then we say that A inverse is the inverse of A. In the similar manner, we have AB equal to 1 equal to BA means B is the inverse of A, but B value is, B is the inverse of A. Similarly, commutative M5, commutative condition, if AB equal to BA for all A comma B belongs to F. A circle B equal to B circle A, then circle is commutative on term. Similarly, A dot B equal to B dot A, then F dot is commutative, that is F is commutative. Now, F is satisfying the 10 conditions. With respect to addition, 5 conditions, and with respect to multiplication, 5 conditions, and addition and multiplication property, that is the third, that is distributive law. Distributive law is also F is satisfying the distributive law. Then we say that F comma plus comma dot is a field. F is a field of, F is a field of two binary operations plus comma dot. The first five conditions is properties of addition with respect to addition, 5 conditions, and with respect to multiplication, another 5 conditions, total 10 conditions. And last 11th condition is distributive law. Distributive law is A into B plus C equal to AB plus AC. That is A into B plus C before A is there. Therefore, A into B, B plus C left side A, it means this is called as left distributive law. That is AB, A into B plus C can be written as A into B plus A into C. For all ABC belongs to A. A, that is called right distributive law. This is not written here. Anyone, distributive law satisfies. Now, F comma plus comma dot is satisfying the all the 11 conditions, then we say that F is a field.
మ్యామ్ మీ వాయిస్ వినిపించట్లేదు మ్యామ్. మీ వాయిస్ వినిపించట్లేదు మ్యామ్.
మీ వాయిస్ వినిపించట్లేదు మ్యామ్.
ఆ నేను మైక్ ఆపిన్నాను అమ్మా. ఓకే ఓకే. ఏం అడిగాను? ఏం అడిగాను మర్చిపోయాను. రికార్డింగ్ ఆపేశాను, మీరు ఏమైనా మాట్లాడంటే మాట్లాడొచ్చు అన్నాను. సరే నెక్స్ట్ రేపు ఏమన్నా లీజర్ పీరియడ్స్ నా టైం టేబుల్ చూసుకొని నేను లీజర్ ఇస్తాను. మీరు ఏదైనా క్లాస్ ఉంటే మళ్ళీ క్లాస్ చెప్పండి. ఉందే
ఓకే మ్యామ్. మ్యామ్ ఒక క్వశ్చన్ మ్యామ్, అదే క్వశ్చన్ బ్యాంక్ ఏదైనా ప్రిపేర్ చేస్తుంటే పెడితే మేము ప్రిపేర్ అవుతాం మ్యామ్.
ఏమ్మా వాయిస్ వినపడటం లేదు నాకు.
క్వశ్చన్ బ్యాంక్ మ్యామ్,
క్వశ్చన్ బ్యాంక్
ప్రిపేర్ చేస్తుంటే మాకు షేర్ చేస్తున్నాను.
క్వశ్చన్స్ ఉన్నాయి కదా
మ్యామ్,
ప్రాబ్లం మధ్యలో క్వశ్చన్స్ ఏదో వచ్చున్నాయి కదమ్మా.
ఎస్ మ్యామ్.
వాయిస్ ఒక నిమిషం డోర్ కాదమ్మా, ప్రాబ్లం మధ్యలో క్వశ్చన్స్ వచ్చాయి కదా.
ఎస్ మ్యామ్.
ఇంపార్టెంట్ క్వశ్చన్స్ అనుకుంటాను. సరేలేండి, లెఫ్ట్ ఇవ్వండి. రేపు ఏ అవర్ కావాలి నాకు లీజర్ నేను పెడతాను. టైం టేబుల్ ఇంకా ఇవ్వలేదమ్మా, ఇబ్బందిగా ఉంది.
మ్యామ్ క్వశ్చన్ బ్యాంక్ ప్రిపేర్ చేశారా మ్యామ్?
ఏమ్మా
క్వశ్చన్ బ్యాంక్ ప్రిపేర్ చేశారా మ్యామ్? క్వశ్చన్స్ మ్యామ్
ఏం చేయలేదమ్మా, ఉండేదే అట్లే పెడుతున్నాను. క్వశ్చన్ బ్యాంక్ ఏం ప్రిపేర్ చేయలేదు.
ఓకే మ్యామ్.
మీకు ఎగ్జామ్స్ ఉంటాయంటున్నారు, మీరు అయినంత వరకు ఫాస్ట్గా ప్రిపేర్ అవ్వండి అమ్మా. ఈ వీక్ నెక్స్ట్ వీక్ కంప్లీట్ చేయమంటున్నారు, షెడ్యూల్ ఇస్తారంటున్నారు కాబట్టి ఇంకొక 2-3 డేస్లో అవి కూడా ఈజీగానే ఉంది, మీరు ఫాస్ట్గా క్యాచ్ చేయొచ్చు. యూనిట్ 2 కూడా ఒక 3-4 డేస్లో అవ్వచ్చు. ఆ లోపల షెడ్యూల్ వస్తే ఎట్లా చూద్దాం, ఒక సండే ఏదైనా క్లాస్ తీసుకునేది. సరే లెఫ్ట్ అవ్వండి. ఓకే ఒక నిమిషం మా, నేను స్క్రీన్ షాట్ తీసుకుంటాను. ఒక నిమిషం స్క్రీన్ షాట్ తీసుకుంటాను. 6x6 ఉన్నారు, వెళ్ళిపోయినారు కదా. సర్లేండి, దానిలో రికార్డ్ అయి ఉంటుంది చూద్దాం. ఓకే లెఫ్ట్ అవ్వండి.